of each of the two groups of members, that is those returned by FCs and those returned by GC through direct elections who are present. I declare motion passed. Third motion, to extend the period for amending the promotion of recycling and pop-up disposal electrical equipment and electronic equipment amendment ordinance 2016 commencement notice 2017, which was laid on the table of this council on the 26th of April 2017. I now call upon Dr. Lo Wai-kwok to speak and move the motion. Thank you, Chair President. I move that the motion as printed on the agenda standing in my name be passed. At the House Committee meeting on the 28th of April, members resolved to set up a subcommittee to study the promotion of recycling and proper disposal electrical equipment and electronic equipment amendment ordinance 2016 commencement notice 2017 to allow the subcommittee sufficient time to report to the House Committee on the finding of its deliberations. I move as chairman of the subcommittee to extend the scrutiny period of the notice to the 14th of June 2017. I appeal to members to support the motion. The foregoing is my speech as chairman of the subcommittee. Here are my personal comments.
The subcommittee is also responsible for scrutinizing the commencement notice as well as regulated electrical appliances ordinance under the producer's responsibility scheme. CAP 603 in August 2008 was passed by the LegCo to introduce the producer responsibility responsibility scheme to reduce the impact on the environment by these various items. In 2010, there was a public consultation on WEEE, that is waste electronic and electrical appliances. In May 2013, there was a blueprint, resources blueprint to 2020, and the administration said that there would be by phases extension of the producer responsibility scheme. After the plastic bag scheme in May 2013, there was the proper, there was this, the bill on a proper disposal of electrical equipment and electronic equipment bill. I was the chairman. The purpose of the bill was to set down a framework to put in place the new regulatory regime for the producer responsibility scheme. At first, it will cover air conditioning, air conditioner, computer, refrigerator, and washing machine. In the manufacturing of these regulated equipment or import such equipment for distribution, then the supplier will have to register as a registered supplier. And there should also be a recycling label provided to consumers. These registered suppliers will have to also provide replacement service, which is, as per the instruction of customers, to remove the old equipment for proper disposal without charging the consumer. Registered suppliers will collect a recycling levy to cover cost. The bill also amends waste disposal ordinance on its coverage to extend to waste regulated equipment when the conditions are met, that is, small-scale dismantling process can be exempted. It has taken close to a year to scrutinize it. On the 17th of June 2016, the second reading and the committee stage was completed. The bill was endorsed to become the Promotion of Recycling and Proper Disposal Amendment Ordinance 2016, and in order to launch the mandatory Producer Responsibility Scheme, the administration wanted to build a facility. And on the 27th of February 2015, the FC approved $548.6 million to develop a facility in Tuen Mun, taking an area of 3 hectares for waste disposal. Later, the EPD, through tendering, signed an agreement with a company for the design and operation of the facility. Every year, the operating cost would stand at $200 million a year. It is estimated that in the middle of the year, the facility will be commissioned that will be able to tackled 30,000 tons of waste, WEEE, which accounts for about 43% of the waste in Hong Kong. These WEEE will be turned into useful material. But as I said in the second resumption of the second debate, I pointed out that the administration should introduce the subsidiary legislation for the scrutiny of the LegCo as soon as possible so that the full implementation of WEEE Producer Responsibility Scheme will be endorsed in 2017. It is clearly seen that this part is an important part to the follow-up work. The commencement notice was gazetted on the 21st of April this year. It was introduced to LegCo on the 26th of April for negative vetting. That is in preparation for further work of disposal of WEEE. The director for EPD is authorized to approve registration and to revoke registration. The schedules containing the list of regulated items will be amended under subsidiary legislation. Also, the director is authorized to adjust the fees level. This piece of legislation came into effect when it was gazetted. There was also amendment to its definition. The director for environmental protection was also responsible for the process of registrations commencing from the 19th of June. Provisions are set down for the detailed operation of the legislation in relation to registration and also decisions relating to these applications. Registered suppliers will have to provide a recycling label for the regulated items. There will be an annual return containing information required and also the replacement services. The director for environmental protection gave notice that the motion would be moved on the 24th of May. However, as per the request of the House Committee, the motion was withdrawn for the subcommittee to have more time to scrutinize the law. I have spent quite a lot of time on the commencement notice and also information about the regulated items, a regulatory regime, in order to explain to my fellow members and also the general public that in relation to the regulation of these WEEE, it has gone through a slow process. A framework was set down. There was not much controversy, but as I've said, that in launching the producer responsibility scheme and also the WEEE scheme, there should be feasible plans put in place. The commencement notice and also the regulation are part and parcel to the regulatory regime. It was estimated on the 19th of June, the application will be open. At the end of this year, the scheme will start and regulation will commence. And I have said to the administration at one point, from drafting, scrutiny, to the law coming into effect and the implementation of the scheme. It covers many different details, and the time frame given may not be sufficient, especially when it comes to adjustment period. On Tuesday, there was a second period, the second meeting of the subcommittee. We have held a public hearing, and you will know if you've listened to that, that I have reflected the concern of the trade. And Jeffrey Lam and also Leung Chee Cheung met the trade a few days ago to listen to them. As I said, when I chair the subcommittee, although the principal legislation covers the entire supply chain, however, the commencement notice and the regulation targets the upper stream of the supply chain, that is, application of for registration and requirements under the removal service. Representatives comes from the trade focused on the downstream side, which is outside the scope of the terms of reference of the subcommittee. So when it comes to the operation of the lowest stream and the transitional period, the administration will have to give them more support. Most of the operators in the low in the downstream section are SMEs. The administration will have to talk further to the administration and to avoid setting the threshold too high when it comes to licensing. They also have to take into consideration the premises of the operators, because it involves many different departments, say for example lands or fire services department. If barriers are not removed, this will hinder the operation of SMEs. I think when the Hong Kong Resources Blueprint 2013 to 2020 was published, all the way to preparing for the principal legislation to putting down the framework of regulation, the administration has done a lot of work, and we can all see that. We can see how hard the administration has worked. But when it comes to implementation, the administration has to consider the operating environment from downstream to upstream. They have to also consider about transitional period for adjustments and take into account all the different comments before it can be successful. Does any other member wish to speak? And I put the question to you that a motion moved by Mr. Lo Wai-kwok be passed. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against, please raise their hands. I think the question is agreed by majority of each of the two groups of members, that is those returned by FC and those by GC who are present. I declare the motion passed.